Hi, welcome to Crit SBI. Today we're going to be going over some free resources for how you can get started in a career in data engineering. Okay. All right, thanks for joining us today. Don't forget to like and subscribe and to hit that bell icon if you want to get more of this great content. We're going to jump right into it. All right. There are a ton of great resources available for you out on the Microsoft Learn site. All of these links are going to be down below. I'm going to be running you through how to use these things so it becomes really easy for you to start working inside this field and making use of these great tools. The Learn site has a ton of different programs that are out there, a bunch of different learning paths. I highly recommend going out and taking a look at these. The one we're going to be talking most about right now is the data engineering role, okay? Inside here, there's 52 different programs that Microsoft has identified that are important for you to learn if you're going to become a data engineer and you're going to work inside of the data engineering space. It's going to cover a lot of the basic things all the way to some more of the advanced concepts. Now, I know what you're saying, like 52 is a lot. So, Chris, where do I get started? How do I get working inside this, before I jump in and just, do I have to get done all 52? Nope, you don't have to do all 52 of these. I'm gonna talk about a couple of these that are my personal favorites before, so you can get started. First one is the Azure Fundamentals program. Now this learning path is close to 10 hours long. And it covers a ton of really important pieces of information just about working and operating inside of the Azure space. If you're going to be doing any work inside of Azure, this is really the first place you should start working in. I've gone through and I've taken this course a couple of times, brushing up on some of the basics. I think it is really important to understand how all of these basics work together in order to build out the best solutions. So honing in and focusing on the basics can really improve the solutions that you're building out and the stuff that you do. All right. The next one is the Introduction to Azure for the Data Engineer. Now, this is only about 2 hours long, and I know what you're saying. Chris, I'm just going to jump over this Azure Fundamentals. I'm just going to go straight into the Azure Data Engineer. I'm going to call that a mistake. Please don't. You can, but really, 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 really important for you to look at these fundamentals before you move on to something more advanced, all right? But the Azure for the Data Engineer program, it's really going to run you through three different modules that you're going to be working on: understanding the evolving world of data, surveying the services inside the Azure Data Platform, and identifying the tasks of a data engineer, right, in a hosted environment, right? These are big key things to understand because number one, this evolving world is truly changing on a very regular basis. Gone are the days where you'd buy a big mammoth data platform that you'd spend a few million dollars on and you'd need that one platform to run and serve your needs for 3, 4, 5 years, right? Now we're talking about this new cloud infrastructure where you're going to be working inside these environments that are, and the where the environments and the tooling are going to be constantly evolving and changing as the needs of the community and needs of data engineers change and evolve over time, right? So understanding how that's going to work and making sure that your systems are built so that they're designed to be flexible enough to manage this evolution is some real new concepts that you should really understand what that means, right? So really important to run through that one. Next one is just the highest level overview of the Azure Data Platform. It's going to run through all of the tooling it's going to run through all the tools that were out there as of when this module was written. It's fairly new, so it is pretty up to date, so still 100% worth it, but you do want to keep very close tabs on the status of what's going on inside the industry because a lot of these things are changing, especially as Synapse is rolling out and all these new tools are continuously rolling out. You'll want to keep up with that, all right? But this is a good foundation for you to get started on when it's understanding what's out there, right? And then the final one is understanding the tasks of a data engineer. So you understand all of the big key components that a data engineer is now going to be tasked with doing as part of this role, right? So either you're a data engineer, like used to working in an on-prem environment, and you're now switching over to working in the cloud, or maybe you're starting from scratch and you're trying to understand what it means to be a data engineer. And frankly, being a data engineer is the right place for a lot of people right now. The demand for data engineering has never been higher. Gartner's saying that it's going to be one of the most popular or most in-demand job positions over the next decade. Highly recommend we spend more, or we get more and more people working inside this space. So if you're watching this video, you're seeing this stuff, you are 100% in the right place. All right, next item. Designing a data warehouse with Azure Synapse Analytics. This is truly starting to be on that cutting edge of technology. This is something that is it's just evolving and it's beginning to roll out. The first piece that's out and generally available is the Azure SQL DW has been renamed into Azure Synapse Analytics, but there's a lot more that's going to come out with this. We're going to start to see the concepts of workspaces in Synapse. We're going to see the ability to import notebooks, direct integration with Power BI. There's a ton of stuff that's going to come out in here. Highly recommend running through this one. Now this one is eight units are inside of this, so it's not as long as I thought it was. So it's a pretty good one to get into. Make sure you check it out. All right. The next piece that I'm recommending is Explain DevOps and CICD, or Continuous Delivery and Continuous Quality. CI. That's wrong. I don't like the name of this. Microsoft, you're wrong. CICD, Continuous Integration, Continuous Delivery, not Continuous Delivery and Continuous Quality. That's weird. No. But whatever, the name of the course is introducing DevOps and CICD concepts to data workers, right? So these concepts were first introduced with applications, and these have been around for 5-10-ish years, somewhere in there. So the concepts are still relatively new inside the tech space. The concept of CICD is actually much easier to implement when it comes to an application. When you're talking about an application maybe having a few hundred megabytes, a gigabyte or two, maybe 3 gigs of code all told, brought together inside their application, it's much easier to manage a CI/CD environment when you're talking about like just moving code between environments. In fact, what you're going to see when you start to look at this and think about how this applies inside the data world is this is a little more, it's much more difficult to implement DevOps and CI/CD inside the data world because of the mass of the data that you have to manage along with this. So being very mindful in how you as a data engineer are going to implement your DevOps and your CI/CD is really, really important. That's why this is one of the first pieces that I recommend, because this is a foundational piece of a cloud-based deployment. So make sure you go through and start to understand this and start to go on that journey from managing your code as colossal masses that you do in the, significant code deployments, all the way through to you have a continuous deployment, continuous integration process running on, all managed through a DevOps pipeline. Okay, 100%, it's 18 minutes. Read this, go through this thing, and it's super important. All right, and then the next piece we're going to start to, the first two or first things we were focusing on was very conceptual, running through those at a high level, understanding how they actually work. I'm going to jump into two specific tools that I think are super important for you to get more into that the Microsoft Learn didn't have. First one is Databricks. As a data engineer, understanding how you can manage your data pipelines and your Apache Spark pipelines using Databricks is going to be key functionality that you're going to need to be able to use, work, and operate in this new cloud space. even as the tooling changes, the concepts of notebooks, the concepts of pipelines that are easily and clearly leveraged inside of Azure Databricks, it's really important for you to understand how to do this. So this is a great site to kind of run you through that on how this all works and whatnot. Fortunately, Databricks also has a community edition with a ton of trainings that are available for you, so you can get started inside this. That's at databricks.com/try-databricks. Again, link below. All you do is go in and sign up, register. You're gonna be asked, do you want a business offering, or do you want the free community edition? Do the free community edition, right? You're just gonna be training. But this edition, you cannot put any type of personal information out there, company information in there. Use the training data sets that are available. It's a great resource. Honestly, you fill this out, you click on a few things, you get an email, and you'll be up and running with your own environment to start working inside of Databricks, literally inside of 5 minutes, okay? Again, I'm gonna have the links in the training, or links down below. The other thing I wanna talk to you about is understanding what is Data Factory. So Data Factory is the pipeline management, Azure data management and orchestration when it comes to managing data as an engineer. Data Factory is gonna be a key tool that you're gonna use even call your Databricks notebooks, to call that functionality, to orchestrate that, to run that through. All of this is gonna be run and managed inside of a Data Factory environment. So really important for you to understand the concepts that are available inside that. All right, I went through all of the introduction to becoming a data engineer really, really fast. There are 52 different courses out here. Highly recommend running through at least the ones I pointed out, and as many of the other ones as you can. The key understanding that I want you to take away is there's tons of free resources that are available for you online. You don't have to go into some big, large college program or really expensive data engineering training class to get up and running inside the world of data engineering. If you like these videos, like, subscribe, hit that little bell icon. That really helps me out. And as always, go out to kratosbi.com. Buy me a coffee if you like this content, want to see it keep going, want to see me adding in new features and functionalities. You want me to start building out content and giving you demos out in Azure. The more coffees you buy, I pump all that money right back into the channel. As you can see, we're starting to get better lighting, better videos. I've got me and Boo here. Are up and running for you every day. But go out to kratosbi.com, you buy me a coffee, and Mince Boo will send you some of these I Love Power BI stickers that we still have. Happy to ship those out to you as a thank you for supporting the channel. Again, thank you very much for watching this content. If you want to be a data engineer, check out the links below. Like, subscribe, all that good stuff. We'll see you guys next time. Bye.